And here we are again. Thanks for joining me on this series about building and managing Dante audio networks using Yamaha's L2 managed switches. Recently, we've learned how to create VLANs, trunks, and seen how to connect multiple switches together in a reliable way. Now, we're going to explore different techniques for redundancy, particularly important in live events and mobile systems. Having backup cables and even backup switches can be a significant advantage for making sure the show goes on. First, let's revisit link aggregation. Remember, this is where more than one cable can travel the same route between switches to increase available bandwidth. Well, if the bandwidth is not needed, the additional cables can be used for redundancy. So, set up two or three ports in a link aggregation group using the web GUI for the Swr2310 series. Or select Dante preset A or B on a SWP1 or SWP2, where the two fiber ports form a link aggregation. And the last two copper ports form a link aggregation group with Dante preset B. Now check the LAN monitor software for the bandwidth percentage of those links. If the sum of the two percentages is 80% or less, it will be safe to run the link with one cable missing. So when both cables are present, the data load is shared between them, and you can adjust the method the switch uses to share the load based on the MAC address of the destination or the IP address, for example. But when one cable gets disconnected, the switch will quickly divert all the data through the remaining cable. Though, don't be surprised if there's sometimes about 1 second of silence after this occurs, but your network connection remains safe. With real-time audio, you may experience a very brief dropout or silence, but sound will recover before you even have time to react. And then, of course, you can use LAN monitor or the web GUI to check what has occurred. So, with Dante preset B and the SWP switches, you can have a copper redundant link between stage left and stage right, for example, and a fiber optic redundant link between stage and control room or front of house. Of course, you could program the same setup for SWR2310 or 11 switch, and with the SWR2310-28GT, you're able to have two fiber optic link aggregations using the four SFP ports. So one 28GT switch could be used in the middle of the network with an 18GT at either end. Actually, each of these switches is capable of hosting 5, 10, or even more link aggregation groups. So even larger networks can benefit from redundant connections between switches. Now let me briefly mention a network switch feature called spanning tree protocol. This is another form of connection redundancy within a network where certain links are left idle until a break occurs. It was often used in legacy CobraNet audio networks, but is not so beneficial for Dante systems. In fact, when a break occurs, it could cause several seconds of silence, which is never a nice experience during a live sound event. So Dante has a better way of dealing with redundancy by using its primary and secondary network connections. We'll get to that in a moment, but just so you know, spanning tree settings can be programmed in the SWP and SWR managed switches, but not via the web GUI. Rather, you need to use a command line interface, which is much more time consuming, so I'm not going to take you there. Instead, let's look at building a secondary Dante network. To do this properly, we need twice the number of switches and twice the number of cables. You exactly duplicate the primary network and connect just the secondary ports after you have checked that no device is still in daisy chain or switched mode, because they would otherwise bridge between the two networks and make the redundancy ineffective. Remember, both primary and secondary networks can make use of the quick Dante optimization settings and the SWP Dante presets. Both networks need to carry clock signals, audio data, and control data. To allow Dante controller software to monitor both networks, use a USB network adapter or another type to give the computer two network ports, one for primary and one for secondary. Then, even if the primary switch fails, the network can still be monitored and controlled through the secondary link. And hear this, there is no noticeable audio dropout when a fault occurs in the primary network. Even when a primary switch loses power, the secondary takes over seamlessly. That is a brilliant system of resilience, though of course it requires extra hardware investment. If that is too much for you, then there is an intermediate solution, and it involves VLANs. Remember a few episodes ago when we programmed two or more VLANs in switches to use for different types of data? Well, we can program one VLAN for Dante primary and another for Dante secondary. However, what we shouldn't do is send both through the same trunk, because it's more likely to overload the bandwidth. We should use separate cables for connecting primary and secondary between switches anyway, to provide the redundancy we wish for. Let's see how it's done with SWP1 and SWP2, because Dante preset C is ideally set up for this. Half the ports are for VLAN 1 and the other half for VLAN 2. The first fiber port is for VLAN 1, the second for VLAN 2. There are no trunks or link aggregations. Looking at the settings in the web GUI, we can see the VLAN assignments to 1 and 2. All ports are for access, no trunks. Notice all ports have EEE stopped. IGMP snooping and querier is enabled for both VLANs to manage any multicast traffic. QoS is enabled to give highest priority to Dante sync data. So basically, both VLANs have Dante optimization applied. Here's how to make the same settings with the SWR2310 switches. First, delete any link aggregation groups, or create additional ones, so you have one for the primary VLAN and another for the secondary. Then create VLAN 2 and label it secondary. Assign half the ports to this VLAN, including any fiber optic module if you have them. Then open the management menu and Dante optimization. Enable the manual setting to instantly prepare both VLANs for use with large numbers of Dante flows. That will set the quality of service and IGMP snooping correctly. Carefully connect Dante primary ports to VLAN 1 and secondary ports to VLAN 2. You can choose to share either VLAN with small amounts of non-Dante data, such as for remote control of mixing desks or wireless mic system monitoring. But now, the Dante system will survive any cable fault without an audio dropout. Of course, if a switch loses power, both networks will be interrupted, and that's the limitation of this method. So it's worth remembering that the SWP switches can have a backup power supply connected. But at least this method can be used to provide increased resilience without such a huge investment. We've got one more episode to go before this series ends. In that video, we'll look at various security options we can use to protect the network. These switches have some special features in that regard. See you again next time.